Hello. So now we are going to deal with the shortcuts, and in today's class we are going to see shift plus F1 to F12, all these shortcuts. Some of them are not there, but the rest we'll see. We have done alone F keys, basically function keys, F1, F2. When you click it, when you click F1 alone, then what happens? In this class, we are going to do that when you use it with a combination of shift. So when you are using shift plus F1, shift plus F2, then what are the shortcuts or what are the description of those shortcuts? Now we'll start with F1. So F1 has no shortcut given as such. Then we have shift plus F2. It leads to a comment. Basically, you can edit or add new comments. So in this cell, if I want to add a comment, then what I do, I click on shift and F2. So I get this comment dialog box. You can simply write any comment you want to, and then just simply click on enter and your comment is saved. So this is how you add a new comment. Also, you can edit a new comment. So shift F2, and you can, your comment box opens up, and you can simply edit the comment, existing comment box. So this is the shift F2. Then we have shift F3, which is the paste function. I'll just make you all understand, is that suppose when I click on equal to, then it states, or when I use a plus sign or minus sign, then it basically, you are telling Excel that you're going to write a new function. But suppose you want to look up for a new function and you want to add a new function over here, then what do you do is you use the shortcut key shift F3. So I'm just going to do shift F3, and we have this insert function dialog box. You have seen this before as well, which is there in the formulas bar as well, formulas tab. You can see that you have this insert function option in the formulas tab. Here it acts like a normal search engine, so you can just write anything. Suppose I click on add and I click go, and you get all the functions which are related to add. So you have sum if, sum product, sum ifs, dsum. So these are basic add functions which you get. You write subtract and you get. So maybe you might find some functions and may not find some functions related to subtraction. So those are the functions. And now when I click on any of this function, it just straight away gives a sum function. You can see in the formula bar there is a sum function, and then you can select your array. So your array can be anything which you specify. For the time being, let us specify this particular array. So I've changed the array to F48 to F54. You can add more arrays as well. What it does is that it will add a comma over here, and automatically it can add new numbers. So I'll just click on OK, and you get the answer as 640. So this is what happens when you use the shortcut key shift F3, which is basically to insert a new function or a paste a function in a particular cell. Then we have shift F4, which is find again, and shift F5 is find. So first, it's basically I'll use F5 first and then the F4, so that it becomes easier for you all to understand. So shift F5, it opens the find dialog box. So let us find Monday over here. So let us try to find Monday. I'll just write Monday over here, and I click on find next. So I have Monday over here as well. So these are the options which I have found. Now what I can do, I'll just click on the close button. So this was basically shift F5, then which opens the find window. Now when you want to search or find the previous found word, then you can again click on shift F4. So shift F4 it will basically find the previous, it finds again the previous word which you found. So see, if you have found maybe something else, if you found maybe Friday, and the very last thing which you found is Friday, so when you click on shift F4, it finds Friday for you. Suppose you have tried to find 4-5 words, Monday, Friday, and maybe shortcut. So these were the words you have tried to find. So whichever is the last word which you found will be, again, you can find that using the shift F4 option. Then we have the shift F6. So it's basically the previous pane. now what is previous pain, now what is pain, we have four pains. One is this ribbon which we have. So this is the ribbon which we have. This is the quick access toolbar. So this ribbon, quick access toolbar, which is the first pain. This ribbon, ribbon, which is the second pane, the sheet which we are working on, the spreadsheet, and then this status bar, you can see in this status bar, is the fourth pane. So these are the four panes you have, and it navigates through these panes. So I'll just click on Shift F6, and you can see we are in the quick access toolbar as well as in the ribbon. Shift F6, and now you can see this plus sign has been highlighted. This plus sign has been highlighted, so I'll just click on F6, Shift F6, I'm back to my spreadsheet, Shift F6, I'm again back to over here, Shift F6, and I'm again back over here. You can see this has been highlighted, the status bar. So this is how you move through the panes when you don't have mouse. So you can just use Shift F6 to move through the panes and use this features over here. Then we have the thesaurus, which is a Shift F7, which you can use, basically you can find the meaning of certain words, thesaurus. So I'll just click on Shift F7, and you have this thesaurus on the right, a small window, research window, and you can just simply write any word you want to search for. Maybe you want to search for Tuesday, so let us, or maybe shortcut, so let us write shortcut over here and go. So you have, you don't have any options for that. Let us write happy and see. Okay, for happy you have many, so it's basically you are getting the words from the UK dictionary over here, and you have content, pleased, glad, joyful, cheerful, basically these are the synonyms for the word happy. This is how you use the thesaurus within the Excel, which is the shortcut key, Shift F7. So I hope this is a very helpful shortcut you have learned. Then we have, for F8 we don't have any shortcuts. Then for Shift F9 we have calculate worksheet. Now again, if you all remember, I'll just go into the files section, and in the options, in the formulas, I'll just change the workbook calculation to manual. And so basically, you every time you do a particular calculation, you need to manually ask Excel that you need to update the calculation. And if it's automatic, it obviously does it automatically. Simply, like, this was the summation of all these numbers. So what do? I just change this 40 to 400 maybe and click on enter. The answer does not change. The answer will not change because I have changed the setting to manual calculation. So unless you ask Excel to do all the calculation, it won't happen on its own. So there are two ways. Again, you can use shortcut key Shift F9. So I'll use Shift F9 and see, it automatically calculates, or you can go to the formulas and you can use the calculate now option as well. Then basically what happens in this, it calculates all the calculation in the entire worksheet. Then we have, the next is the context menu. Now what is the context menu? Whenever you right click anywhere on your spreadsheet, this is the menu which you get, and this menu is nothing but the context menu. You can simply cut, paste, add, insert, or whatever you want to deal with. So if you don't have a mouse, basically if your mouse is not working, your right click is not working, then what do? When you want to get the context menu, use Shift plus F10. Shift plus F10, and see, you get the context menu, and you can just click on the down arrow, up arrow to just navigate through your menu section. So this is how you use the and just click on the escape button for the menu to go. So that was the context menu. And then we have Shift F9, which is the new worksheet. So when you need to open a new worksheet, I have many number of worksheets over here, so I'll just click on Shift F11, and it takes me to a new worksheet, which is sheet 2. It has formed a new worksheet. So this is how you can simply create a new worksheet. And also we'll deal with these shortcuts, so I'll just explain you. Now I want to go back to my shortcuts sheet. So how do I do without using my mouse? I'll click on Control Page Down. Control Page Down takes me to this particular worksheet. We'll talk about this in our control shortcuts. Basically, control page down and control page up allows you to navigate through the sheets. I'll just go back and delete this because it's not required for the time being. Then we have the Shift F12, which is the save option which you get. So if you are using a new workbook, then you get the save as option, and if you are updating an existing workbook, then you normally save the workbook. So Shift F12, and you can see it normally save the workbook. Shift F12 and the cursor, you just look at the cursor, it just blinked once and it saved your workbook. So that was the Shift plus the function keys shortcuts. Thank you.